There we go. Now we can do the update asynchronous. It's launched. Crank that up. I want to make sure the sound is working. Oh, wait. Yep, it's working. I did them out of order. Oh no, the game's gonna freak out because they did them out of order. I have Crypto the Necrodancer music stuck in my head.
Straight. 3, 2, 1, go! Alternate bringing your knees up to touch the ring con. This stretch targets the area between the thighs and glutes. Last time. Yes, just like that. Next is the heel lift stretch. Bring the insides of your ankles up toward the ring con. Breathe out as you raise your ankle. Last time. All right.
Oh.
Good. Next is the back straight. Take a big step forward and drop your hips. Don't let your knees move too far forward. Make sure your toes are pointed straight ahead of you. Let's do one more of each. Yes, looking great. Finally, spread your feet. Raise the ring con above your head and lean to the side. Be sure to keep your lower back straight. As you exhale, begin to lean. Let's do one more of each. Great job.
Oh, and fix this. Here. Oh. Another day, another ring fit session. All right, I finished off last session with boss fight. Good job, Mike. Oh my god, you're telling me I cleared the world, right? Yeah, I cleared the world. Woohoo. Worth it. Alright, anyway. Oh god, I need to wear a hat, I'll tie more soap. I'm gonna complain about this for only a little bit, but man. Yeah, I know. It's getting to be.
Okay, time to run.
Alright. That rattles a lot. It's getting to be the summer months, yeah?
Yeah, nice.
It's getting to be the summer months. So, the sun's out more.
Okay.
And people are going outside more, myself included. But the unfortunate downside of finally going outside, especially after this whole last year of nobody go outside, is even more so than normal. Parallel. Is even more so than normal. I am getting sunburnt. Like, it might not show up in the camera too well. It may not show up in the camera all too well, but my arms are red. I've got some color in my face, so I don't think I got sunburn there yet. And the top of my head hurts. Because even though I still have mostly a full head of hair, I'm getting on age, so my hair is falling out a little bit, and I forgot to eat a boost up. Got to eat a boost. Let's stop for a second and do that. See? Just like that. A whole bunch of materials. 10 items, I think is what I just got. Push, stop. Push, walk a little bit, push, there we go. Hey, look, it works.
Doing great. Yay!
And combat.
Check the enemy's color.
Well,
select a skill.
We'll start with Warrior 2 poses then. Move on from there.
Okay, let's switch sides. Don't forget to switch legs.
And all I gotta say about that is, if you're someone like me who normally hates hats, doesn't have a hat, think about investing in a hat, at least one.
Because
I hate wearing hats, but the march of time makes fools of us all.
You should feel it in your
stomach, eventually,
not your arm.
You gotta check your cranium. Don't glance at me that way. I don't owe you money. Yet. So kind of a little different from the normal is kind of a little different from the normal, what we do for these streams, or what I do for stream days, is normally I wait until after I stream to eat something. But because I've been up so early today, or because I woke up so early today, I actually already had my dinner. That kind of stunted when I started streaming today. Yeah, my stream today got stunted a little bit because I ate dinner before the stream, and this thing I've been having an issue with lately. Is as soon as I have dinner, my body wants to go into full comatose mode. And I've recently been having to fight it. I've recently been having to fight my body a little bit more on that and go, no, sleep time is it now. Sleep time it is in a little bit. Oh, working as lost as ever. Issue I had 2 nights ago now? Yeah. Issue I had 2 nights ago now was I ate my dinner. I ate my dinner and I went to bed. But then I woke up at 9 o'clock. So like 6 to 9 o'clock. Okay, whatever, it's a nap.
You did it!
It's a nap, we just deal with that. But the secondary part of that is I woke up at, you know, I stayed up late, and then when I attempted to go to bed later, which was at 5 in the morning, I didn't. I lay in bed for a half an hour. My body would zoom, zang, bang, bang, do all the things. And I said, oh, please, body, no. And it said, oh, yes. So I stayed up yesterday. Yeah, it's yesterday now. Yesterday I was awake from, well, let's see, I was up since 9, and then I didn't go to bed again until 1 o'clock the next day, which was yesterday, and then I woke up at 4, had dinner about 7, went back to bed at 7:30, woke up at 12:45, took care of some social media business, and then went back to bed at 1:30, waking up at 8 in the morning today. So I've had probably too much sleep in all actuality.
Or you're too pope.
But it's all started because my body has now fallen into this trend of, you ate a meal, you get an itis.
Collarbone to the right and the left.
switch sides. Don't forget to switch legs.
So yeah, that has been a wonderful last 3 days of sleeping like absolute crap. Although, some worry in my head has been put to rest now.
Slowly return to the starting position. Relax and don't strain your shoulders.
Yeah. Oh, I gotta check something next really quick before I speak too much further, but a little bit of my worried has been put to rest now, because I think, like, the day after I last streamed, I think that, I guess I was talking so much about on Ring about the recently about how my CPAP had busted. Sorry, I need to check something really quick because it's now in the front of my mind. I want to make sure the message I sent to somebody isn't false. Okay, yeah, I had to make sure of this. Alright. Sorry about that. Personal thing I need to check on. Okay, it did spit on me. That's what I thought it would do. But anyway, so like, I'm pretty sure I talked about at great length about how my CPAP busts and all that jazz. Last week on Friday, I actually think I got a phone call from the providers of CPAPs, and they were like, yes, we can, we're going to send out a replacement CPAP unit to you. So expect that in the mail within a week. And I'm hoping it shows up by tomorrow. Like a decent night's sleep before plans I have on Saturday. But another thing correlates to the thing I was excited about last month, me getting a new car. I was excited to get the car, not excited to have monthly car payments again. But okay, that's not gonna be enough. It's not gonna be enough, it's not gonna give me the gimme. But anyway.
Feel it in your stomach while you breathe out.
So people I got the car loan through, or I guess the dealership told me, yeah, the people you got the car loan through, they're gonna send you how to set everything up in about. I'll just do this. They're gonna send you details on how to set everything up in about. In about 10 business days. Okay.
This will work your upper chest. Alright!
Nice. And today being the... Today was the 15th business day since I got the car. So basically, I was basically either tomorrow or sometime next week after the holiday, I was going to call out and say, hey, It's been almost a month, and they haven't said a word to me. Should I call in? But luckily, the loaner, or the people who gave me the loan for the car, finally got the letter to me today. So I got that set up, and that little worry and that little headache is now out of sight, out of mind, as they say. Ooh. We're gonna start doing that already.
Turn your exercise into experience points with a victory pose. Charge your squat power, but don't over-release toward victory!
Lightly cover the IR motion camera with the pad of your right thumb as shown. Measuring. Please do not move your thumb.
Anyway. So yeah, a few of my worries have been put to rest now, finally.
Sorry, I couldn't measure properly.
That just tells me this thing needs to get recalibrated properly. But yeah, as I said, most of that worry was taken care of and kind of thrown off my head and whatnot. I guess another thing that had happened over the course of this week. What you guys doing? Steps or less in this one, huh? Okay, that's pretty easy. Yeah, so I bought several like old games, and I just tried to play one of them the other night for the first time. I bought it like 4 months ago. No, like 2 months ago. Yeah, I bought the game in question like 2 months ago. And I finally put it in the system. And it didn't work on startup, so I thought I had... Oh, right, it's boosh. I thought it was, hip sway. But yeah, I put the game into the system about 2 months the other night after it basically was past the, return by date. So, I thought I just had a faulty game and I was gonna have to cut my losses and, you know, just agree to the fact that I had wasted about 30, 35 bucks on the game that I had thought that I had pretty much all sorted away. But when I was trying it, luckily, I was in a call with some friends and they said, oh, well, it is a cartridge-based game. It's a cartridge-based game. Have you tried sticking it? Have you tried sticking a cotton swab in it or hitting it with rubbing alcohol to kind of clean off the things? Clean off the ends of it. And make sure the connection's proper on it. And I was thinking, you know, I haven't, but if I damage the game at this point, nothing lost. So, I clean off the ends of the cartridge with a cotton swab, and the first time I stick it in the system, after that, it just boots right up, no questions.
You did it!
Now I have no idea how long this course is, so I have no idea if I've almost flubbed it or what. No, I think I've got it. Considering I got the third medal. Considering I've gotten the third medal now, and I've got less than half the required steps left to go, or limit of steps rather. In fact, I can see the end right there. In fact, I can probably just run the rest of it on foot.
Go! Drop your hips. Victory!
So then, I took that. So yeah, so I did that. And then I have another N64 game here that I bought. It's old. I was like, okay, let me just chunk-a-wonk-a-bunker that thing in to the system and see what happens. You know, I haven't moved my hand. Thank you. So I've had another game that I slammed in the system. It's like, okay, that one works. New formula, you say? Oh, let's see. So I'm gonna get a freebie, which is some wheatgrass, nice. Helianum, and I'll leave at stage B. And I'm gonna go to the shop, and then we're gonna hit up everything else around here before we loop back around to Drago Stadium. And then I'm gonna do that a couple times, apparently. Okay, honey, let's see what you got. Well, I will buy it, but I will not equip it. Because moving faster means that I burn less calories. And you know what we say about burning less calories? Sure, I guess I'll do that. We'd say no to burning more calories. I thought I had two peridots. Oh, I got two peridots actually from this. So I have two bits of equipment to buy, and I need two peridots to do it. Now you don't sell onion or anything else like that, do you? No. And although I do need to buy some sesame seeds. I'll buy 15 for now. And no. You know, let's sell some stuff that I have like 99 of. Clear my inventory ever so slightly. Like these Ashitaba. These are all healing things. I'm not going to use these anytime soon. Let's sell 50 of them. 55, sure. These? Sell 50 of these as well. 53, sure, why not? This stuff I have an ungodly amount of that I will never use. Chard? It's been forever since I've had to use any chard. Basil? I don't think I've used any. And if I have, it's been negligible amounts. I'll leave the bee stick plant because it's actually new. And that doesn't fetch a pretty penny at all. But like down here, there's like milk or something. There's some milm. I have something way down here that, yeah. Just basic milk. Just sell a whole bunch of milk. Who's gonna miss it? You? I mean, it's not gonna be me. Strawberries? I haven't used these in a fine year. Green tea leaves? I barely made anything that uses green tea because I don't focus on yoga all that much. Or potions in general. There. I probably shouldn't have sold it because it would have increased the amount of greens I would have gotten otherwise, but tomato, tomato. Potato, patata. Excuse me, Mr. Mysterio. You want to go ahead and try something else to get yourself some quick money? Here's another thing I can tell you that will bring you clear, sod off. Oh, drink this really quick. Car crash outfit, let's go! Time for some mountain climbers. Oh god. That's probably the most strenuous thing I'm gonna do this entire stream is these mountain climbers. I just saw something glean off my Rincon, and now I'm getting a little upset thinking this Rincon has come apart, even though I've been much nicer to it than anything else I've any of the other Rincons I've used. Whew. Like that. Okay.
There we go.
Oh, hitting the laundry basket. Hold on.
Move super
energetically. For a while there.
Big, wide motions.
40.
20 more. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Make big, wide motions. Right, left, right. 10 more. Left, right, left. Right. 5.
Holy cow. Stamina today.
Right, left, right, left. You made it! Stand up. No need to rush, though.
But also, as I tell people, it's very hard.
You should feel it in your stomach.
It's very hard to move around 250 pounds. But imagine how much harder it is to move around. Imagine how much harder it is to move around 360 pounds.
Select the skill.
Alright. So whatever I want, you say?
Russian twist. You made it! Stand up! No need to rush,
They're going to make the Rincon stand up to more pressure. And
feel it in your stomach.
They need to add it, so they need to fix it so that if you're doing a single targeting skill, it switches to the next target almost instantly. Especially in a situation like this. Oh no, I should do this. I've done plenty of Warrior 2 poses today.
Okay, let's move. Hold the ring con like a bow. Alright! Nice! Good job! Amazing! Fantastic! Perfect! Yes! Yes! Neat!
Man, that kettlebell just has so much defense and or health. There it goes, good lord. Oh, that hurt.
Okay, let's go. Hold it away from your face to aim. All right. Wonderful.
Yeah, the controller desyncing is not helping most of these exercises today.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Excellent.
I shouldn't say desyncing.
Fantastic.
Rather. The drift is affecting something, either the ring con or the Joy-Con.
Very nice. That was amazing.
And I'd be a little upset if it's the Joy-Con, because this is a newer Joy-Con, and I'd be upset if this is the ring con, because once again, this thing is only a couple months old and it's having issues. Also, thanks to my doctor's visit last week. I never said it on stream, but because I know I do have a couple people who watch from outside of America, I always say 250 pounds, which is my official doctor's scale, and not a bathroom scale, or what I was using beforehand, a pallet scale. By a specific doctor numbers, a very well-programmed doctor scale.
When you want to vacuum something up, just pull on me from both sides.
I am 250 pounds.
Score!
Or, in all the parts of the nation, 114 kilograms. Which, in relation, like the average male is like 104 kilograms. So, I feel good about myself. That's all I gotta say in the end. Alright. Well, I will finish with mountain climbers, but I'm starting off with this. Because I'm not ready for more mountain climbers right this second.
Great! Okay! Fantastic! Great! Okay! Nicely done! Well done! Wonderful! Excellent! Nice! Good job!
So,
keep it up. Yeah.
So other things that are going on around the internet. I know, let's see. I think right now is the state of play for Sony. Or at least in the next little bit, it's going to be state of play for Sony, if I remember right.
Amazing.
So we can't talk about that, obviously, because I'm not going to watch that while streaming. Especially if I do that, it's going to blow out everybody's ears. And especially because I'm not a huge Sony advocate. Like, if Mr. Sony wants to show up and says, hey, here's a PlayStation 5, all you have to do is talk about the fact you have a PlayStation 5, I'm not going to say no. But me, myself, I'm probably not going to invest in anything PlayStation for a while. Anything additional in PlayStation, I should say. Anyway, so, but yeah, I know yesterday, last night there was a Dragon Quest presentation, because along with Legend of Zelda and Metroid having its 35th anniversary this year, so is Dragon Quest, or Dragon Warrior, whichever you prefer to say. I didn't watch Dragon Quest presentation because even though I acknowledge it as a very necessary and long-withstanding RPG series,
okay, let's select the skill.
I have yet to get invested in Dragon Quest. Not to say I haven't tried in the past, but just it's one of those series that's been so long running that even though I have some of the games in the series to go with, it's hard for me to get into and stay into that series. And though they've had spin-offs and whatnot that have probably been more interested to me outside of RPGs, I still just, I don't know. It's very hard for me to do so. Give a quick smack on top, see if that fixes anything. But the big takeaway from that is, you know, Mr. Dragon Quest said, by the way, 12th mainline entry in the series coming sometime soon. And which is pretty impressive considering Echoes of an Elusive Age, Dragon Quest XI, the Definitive Edition, just came out to like all consoles in the last year and a half. That's impressive because with that knowledge in the back burner, that is a lot of, you know, a lot of people now have like a year and a half to finish up Dragon Quest XI if they haven't yet. I'm calling myself out. I did more than what the game is showing there. I know that for a fact. Whew. Lightheaded. Sorry. Thought I had a message. One second here. Whew. So, but I know that happened. What was it? I know that little bit of news happened last night, which was during my stint of sleep that I put off way too much and caused me to be very, the sleep I didn't have, I finally got it, but I missed a lot of news. But anyway, so that leads us up to today for news announcements, where I, like many other people, watched the Sonic thing today. Didn't record it, didn't do any kind of reaction to it, even though I think part of my brand is synonymous with bad Sonic. Quote unquote bad Sonic. I was doing a little bit of video work this morning and I stopped. I just got the preliminary steps of editing done and I stopped to watch the Sonic event. Literally, it was literally all a mobile game showcase, collaborations within our other Sega ISPs. Oh yeah, here's Sonic Colors HD. And at the very end, a 45-second trailer of, we can't even tell what the name is. It's either Sonic Zap, Sonic Up. Nobody knows. Because the logo they gave it is confusing. And as soon as that was done, I'm not talking about Sonic, I'm about to start running. As soon as that was done, you know, I being me, and trying to play damage control, you know, went to Twitter immediately and said, hey, you know, keep your expectations low or lower.
You did it!
This is Sonic we're talking about. This is Sega and Sonic Team we're talking about right now. They gave us Sonic Forces. And thankfully, it was only one mutual friend, but I had one mutual friend go, oh yeah, I forgot about the classic trilogy, or the classic quadrilogy pack.
Drop your hits.
That's coming out sometime late this year.
Victory!
Which I guess I'm excited for, but you know, they said, hey, I don't know, man. I don't know, I'm hype. But I too was hype for Sonic Forces, and you're reminding me of how I was disappointed. Listen, I know exactly. As a struggling Sonic fan, I understand the hype. I too was hype for Sonic 06 and Sonic Lost World. And I would say Sonic Unleashed as well, but I actually like Sonic Unleashed, so I'm exempt from the fact that I actually enjoyed that game that everybody else dunks on. Oh boy, I have to do two of these before I can move forward. Wunderbar. Okay. Well, I know what I'm going to do. Because I haven't done any of these yet today. With that Sonic Up or Sonic Zap, whatever the hell they're calling it.
Great! Amazing.
There have been rumors floating out around about it and theories. So
okay. Amazing.
The theory that a lot of people are coming to
Fantastic.
Is well, the theory that a lot of people are coming up with is, hey, it was Sonic, but there was
nice.
Pink sparks flying off of his shoes. In the last, like, 5 seconds of that trailer.
Well done.
It must be a game centric around Sonic and Amy teaming up or something like that.
Good job!
Which, okay, I'll buy. I'm not gonna be mad at that. Though I'm not the biggest advocate for Amy, I think she's a fine character, especially because they've fine-tuned her over the last few years to make her still the
fine work.
Incessant stalker, but actually a good character outside of that. Character tree.
Fantastic.
But the other one I saw
Perfect.
Was apparently somebody got to like pre-alpha test a build of the game, and they went on 4chan and just spouted off like, yeah, it's an overworld Sonic game that's got RPG elements. Thanks Sonic for Breath of the Wild. And I'm here
Very
thinking.
Nice.
Okay,
Wonderful.
That's different. I may enjoy
okay.
that because I like Breath of the Wild.
Excellent.
But if that's what's going to happen, I can already tell you,
Very nice.
People are going to dunk hardcore
awesome.
If that's what that Sonic Up or Sonic Zap
Indeed.
Is actually going to become. It's an
Amazing.
Overworld Sonic game. Like, they are going to dunk on it so hard. Like, there's potential... There's potential the game could actually get review bombed
right.
or get worse reviews than Sonic Forces.
Fine work. Sharp.
I would love to be pleasantly surprised and proven wrong,
well done.
But
Wonderful.
I also know where I am, the internet, and what to be expected, the worst.
Okay. Challenge yourself. Great. All right. You made it! Stand up! No need to rush, though.
Okay, let's do thigh presses because I haven't done these yet today.
Okay, let's move. Breathe out when you close your legs. Yes! Yes! Very nice! Excellent! Awesome! Nice!
Well, I find
Perfect.
It kind of weird. Funny that E3 is in less than, or E3 is like 3 weeks away, I think. But there's a whole bunch of companies just going, yeah, here's our games coming out. Just take this news and eat it. You know you love it.
Nicely done.
Meanwhile, a lot of us are like, if you wait 3 weeks, you can join in on the hype train with everybody else during that time of year when everybody gets hyped for games. Instead, They're being the big dumb and dropping all their news now. Instead of waiting that additional month, maybe getting a little bit more information together so when they release information about it, they can build up proper hype with possible gameplay. Or fleshing out enough of the story to go, okay, this is how much of the story we want to tell people. So when we unveil more gameplay information, they know exactly what story is going to come with that. But no. Unfortunately, we're kind of in an age where divulging game information as early as possible is the only way to get hype for something. Like, the best way I can describe it is that if I were to stand here before you today and say, I'm going to give you day one Let's Play footage of Mario Golf Super Rush. Day one. I don't know how it's even going to function, but day one, you're getting that. And then I have to be like, oh God, I actually have to get that to them starting on day one. Which means the day it comes out, I have to sit down and record part one, edit and upload part one immediately before I can record parts 2 through 5.
Fantastic. Amazing.
And hope that episode one is an absolute banger of an episode. Otherwise, nobody's going to stick around long enough to watch episodes 2 through 70.
Okay. Sharp.
But that's not a here nor now problem for me, because I never promise I'm gonna do a series until I'm like a week away from doing it. Because I like to keep expectations low. In relation to all that news coming out, you know,
you should feel it in your stomach.
Sonic fans are like the slowest to learn that things can suck and not to wait until the news actually surfaces before they go throw money at it. Keep in mind, I'm calling myself out with this too.
Keep going.
Because this right here that you see in my hand, that you can tell just without me getting closer, this right here in my hand, this is my day one $60 full price purchase of Sonic 06. Because who reads reviews? Who waits for reviews? But come on now. The Sonic community doesn't know how to wait for a review score, something they're skeptical on. They have a switch that's either full hype or complete abashment of anything. This includes things that are not Sonic. And they don't know to approach with cautious optimism. To which I remind people, the best-selling Sonic game in the last 10 years is Sonic Mania. A fan-made Sonic game with the blessing of Sega saying, yes, this is fine, we will consider this an official product. And I guess I have my own little fan theory about that, that Sonic Mania did so well without Yuji Naka out there heading it. So he got salty and butthurt over it and went off and tried to make Balan Wonderworld. And that flopped hard. Which makes me think and wonder, well, I know Iizuka-san is heading Sonic now without Naka, without Yuji Naka out there to give his creative, massive air quotes, creative input. It does make me wonder now if, like, if Yuji Naka will not have any input on this on the new mainline Sonic game. And because of that, if what happens is if the next major Sonic game goes on without Yuji Naka running the ship, and it sells about as well as Sonic Mania does in the long run, that's going to have Sega and Sonic Team looking at Yuji Naka and go, bro, you're off the team. What do you mean off the team? You're off the team. The last three games you've been producer and or director on have been massive flops. You're off the team. I'm not gonna do Mountain Clams for two.
Okay, let's go. This exercise targets your legs. Me? Yes! Yes! Okay!
Like, no ill will to anybody in any job position, but...
Awesome! Well done! Amazing!
If the major half of all of your money inflow... Fantastic. Or I guess half and half, because games only make up half of what Sonic is now.
Perfect.
If a quarter of your major money inflow for your company consistently flops... And when you remove one person and you suddenly you're gaining more money without that one person, that person has to be held accountable or removed.
Excellent. Great. Okay. Sharp.
Like I feel like, you know, if what I'm saying happens, I feel like it'd be like an Inafune syndrome again. Keiji Inafune, creator and lead director of Mega Man on Mega Man 1 Very through nice. 8 and X through
Perfect.
Excuse me, X through X5?
Okay. Fantastic.
I think that's what Inafune did.
Okay.
Or I think Inafune did those Mega Man specifically.
Fine work. Great. Keep it up. You got it.
Maybe it's through X6 and 7.
Okay.
But like
Inafune
stopped doing Mega Man,
rush,
then Mega Man 9 and Mega Man 10, and I think even Mega Man X8, potentially, and 11 came along, and those did better than some of the later Mega Man entries overall, so they got rid of Inafune. Inafune went, well, I'm going to make my own Mega Man, make my own original IP, my own original character, and then that game flopped. The parallel being Yuji Naka with Balan Wonderworld. And now it's just like, why do we keep you here? You're actually trying to drag the series down in the mud. Go. I don't even know if Inafune is doing work anymore. That's how bad it is. I think Inafune is out of the game creation sphere as far as I'm aware. And if I'm wrong, somebody can please correct me on this.
Slowly return to the starting
Man.
Let's switch sides. Don't forget to switch
lessons
sides.
Being learned here. Do not eat spicy food before going into the public. Sorry. OCD kicked in. Something was distracting me over there. What else? Like, I don't know how old Mr. Naka is, or I should say Naka-san. I don't know how old that man is, but if he's producing flops on everything he has now, and he's over the age of 50, he might want to consider retirement before it gets worse. Yep. Like,
you should feel it in your stomach, not your arms.
Yeah, something's not right in the controller somewhere around here. Something is losing its grip somewhere in this upper edge of the controller. The connection is not acting as it should.
Great! Wonderful!
There we go. Okay. So, okay, that is Final Run, sorry. I know something on my foot, so I'm taking care of it really quick. Alright. I did space out perfectly. Let's go, more Russian twists. There we go.
You made it! Stand up. No need to rush, though.
I at least wanted to get rid of that one little bugger.
You should feel it in your stomach when you breathe out.
Yeah, I haven't let go. Excuse me for 1 minute. Well, I proceeded to beat the unit, so it functions like it should.
You can do it.
Wow, it's actually functioning. Apply some blunt force trauma to something and it starts working. Fantastic, huh?
Five more.
Okay, armrest.
Amazing.
Arms of spaghetti, man. Hang now. I just saw it. Figured it. Thought I was gonna be able to try and handle it right away, but nope. I'll have to handle it on my own time after the stream. But nobody else has to steer me trying to address the issue. There we go. I forgot to do the Dole Money drink. Oops. Oh. Culo. My reward is a recipe. Can my reward be another peridot? No, we keep going. Have I gotten a peridot? There's probably better ways to find out if I have, but I'm gonna check this way first. No, I'm not. Oh, man. Oh, Lobster Studio. This one's part of my normal rotation. This level's part of my daily rotation. Whenever I... When basically it's a rainy day outside. And I just remembered. I can do this, and I can get the double ingredient smoothie going.
Yeah, doing good.
Wow, I've been trying to push that for the last 2 minutes, and then it finally took over. King Conda from Kryptonectant just still stuck in my head.
Amazing! Excellent! Excellent!
done. Okay, defense. Good. I'm gonna do enough back presses here that I don't need to worry about doing it during this bit, so let's do more leg raises.
Okay, let's move. This will target your ass. Neat. Excellent. Great. Amazing. Great. Okay. Sharp. Okay. Keep it up.
Oh, Jesus. Sorry.
Nice. Fantastic. All right. Amazing. Good job. Oh. Wonderful.
I guess that's what I get for eating dinner before streaming. Yeah, huh? Damn.
Great. Sharp. Yes. Yes. Awesome. Okay.
There it goes.
Good fight. Doing great.
Oh, geez, John. Leaves.
Okay.
There we go. That's the word. Anyway.
Russian twist.
I was curious how much we've burned off so far. I'm healing.
Left, right, ten more. Left, right, left. Five more. Left, right.
And if it does call something back, it's not a 1 in 3 chance there will be anything that's abuse.
Abdominal twist press rush. You should feel it in your stomach when you breathe out. Select the skill.
Really? More power, huh? Yeah, we're gonna get rid of you. But we're calling in the troops.
Okay, let's go. Breathe out when you close your legs. Fantastic! Excellent! Sharp! Okay! Awesome! Great!
Got rid of the buffer, ally reviver.
With your legs bent slightly, squeeze. Lucky break. Be sure to stay hydrated.
Ow. Oh, okay. Down we go.
Okay, let's go. Keep your hips still as you twist your body. Yes! Yes! Wonderful! Very nice! Amazing! Great! Yes! Yes! Nice!
it's dead. Okay, cool.
Great job. Go drink some water.
Topaz, come on, we're past that now. Repeat after me. Perido. Perido. Agua. Perido.
Quick! Let's hurry out of here!
There.
Drop your hips.
Try again, you drunk son of a gun. Is that the last continue screen? Yeah, it's probably the last continue screen. Alright. That's the battle with 85 calories. Which, if all of it works out well, should put us at 400, 410. Depending on how long this takes, this may be the last thing we do tonight. Okay, ring, we're looking over here, according to you. You know what? I'm not feeling it right now. So let's A, double down our money. But B, double down on our power.
Russian twist. Twist. Left, right, chance. Abdominal twist press rush.
All right, get the rush him down too. Bad doggy.
Bunch of skill and attack.
I shouldn't, but I'm speeding this. I'm gonna speed this up. An attack power doubler. You know what? That works. Attack power double doesn't give me health, it gives me defense, and that's exactly what I got.
Okay, let's move. Be sure your wrists, elbows, and shoulders are all good. All right! Well done! Excellent! Excellent! Fantastic! Wonderful! Okay!
Arms are sore. Hold on. And I need some more water. Ooh. Don't breathe water. It's a bad idea. Ooh. We all live in a Pokemon world. Don't know why I started singing. Ending Pokemon ending one, but I did.
Very nice. Awesome.
There. The buffer and Rezzer is dead.
Good job.
Hope is to get rid of the debuffer by the time we're done with this set.
Yes. Yes. Fantastic.
Never mind, it's not close.
Nice. Excellent. One left. Excellent.
There.
You should feel it in your stomach, not your arms. You've got this.
That's a lot of pup. Even though it's weak to Fat Press, I'm going to go in order of what smoothies I drank, just because I know the effects are going to wear off either this turn or next turn.
Okay, let's move. Challenge yourself by keeping your feet off the ground. Me? Keep it up! Okay! Excellent! Fine work! Nicely done! Excellent! Amazing!
Whew. Yeah. I think I made the right call saying this might be the last event we do tonight. Because holy cow. I am beat. Beat more than Homemade Mochi right now.
Okay! Fantastic! Nice! Perfect!
Wow. I can almost read the name in that box in front of me. Sorry. I have something over here that has a katakana and I can read part of what it says. Oh, no.
Yes! Yes! Amazing!
It's gotta be that.
Okay!
Yeah.
Wonderful!
It's gotta be Hako. Hako something something box. Anyway, continuing.
Yes! Yes!
Oh, this may take a while to get through. I've kind of hit that point of no steam left in the engine.
Oh.
Doesn't this guy have like a big attack priest in here? I remember like all bosses have, for the most part, every single boss in this game just has a massive attack.
Feel it in your stomach when you breathe out.
That you counterattack, use it against them as a counterattack, and it chunks away just enough their health bar, where it doesn't, where you no longer feel like you're having a problem fighting it. I'm gonna be a little lazy on this one. Oh, that's that rule in katakana. I'm learning things by looking at OL.
Fantastic! Perfect! Alright! Amazing! Great! Great! Excellent! Amazing! Okay! Keep it up! Deep! Sharp! Okay! Good job! Amazing! Yes! Yes!
Yeah.
I feel a powerful attack coming.
Every boss has some kind of big boy powerful attack.
It won't be easy, but use your Abgar to ride it out. Lower your hips. Hold in on the ring top. Keep bending your legs.
Still going.
A tough one, but you can do it.
Oh, a little bit dizzy. Give me a second. My heart is racing. Okay, it's gonna be disgusting. Give me 1 second. Allergy season still. Still a lot of Crap, my throat. Not in this. Six right now, with the power and time.
Excellent! Amazing!
We'll definitely
nice.
Crush the rest. We'll definitely finish up to 400 calories burned.
Very nice!
In a second here.
Okay.
Or at least by the time we finish this boss fight.
Good job.
This is the 1 hour mark.
Excellent!
So now that I'm over an hour.
Well done.
Let's look at this screen.
Wonderful!
To see how many more calories we have to go. 21? Easily achievable.
Great! Perfect! Okay! Nicely done! Fantastic! Very nice! Awesome! Good job! Fantastic! Great! Keep it up!
Excuse me. And again. And a third time.
Excellent! Alright! Okay, increase your pace! Okay! Alright! Fantastic! Neat! Come on! Keep it up! Excellent! Okay! Good job! Great! Okay!
Okay.
No need to rush.
Though. No bonus. And I have a ping.
With your legs bent slightly, squeeze.
Probably not my luck of matchmaking ping.
Don't push it. Take a break if you need to.
Yeah. Okay, interesting pings.
Evolved crescent lunge pose.
See if I can do this without falling over. My rug's getting. My carpet's getting smooth back here.
Slowly twist to the left. Slowly return to the starting point. This is good for exercising your lower body, abs, and back. Okay, let's switch sides.
Ow.
Don't forget to switch legs.
Oh, that hurt.
You should feel it in your stomach, not your arms.
Oh, that one hurt a lot. Hold on. I'm lightheaded. Give me a second. We're gonna finish this fight. I just need a minute. Oh, see Christmas. Santa's Estancia. Ayúdame. Call me madre. Hold on a second. I just realized there is less stuff. There's less stuff in the Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition, Collector's Edition. Definitive Works. Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Works Edition of Xenoblade Chronicles. Then there is less content, but it's bigger than the Xenoblade Chronicles 2 Special Edition. Oh, man, I need some of my other games to get here. I got towering. I got stuff falling over, man. Okay, I'm better.
Okay, let's move. Press in on the ring. Great! All right! Excellent! Yes! Yes! Amazing! Well done! Perfect!
Oh, arms hurt. Hold on. You can tell the exercise regimen is working. My arms hurt. But it's also the fact that, once again, I'm over an hour of actual moving and exercising time. And most people will be done after half an hour. Again, I'm not most people because I know I'm a glutton, so I have to overwork myself to make up for the things I do that I shouldn't eat.
Work.
gonna get close. But I'm not gonna hit the 400 calorie mark on this set. It's gonna be in whatever I pick next. I like how he teleports to get punched. You can tell the animations are a little canned. Okay, 10 more short ones, let's go. This is gonna be the finisher. Because this will put me like right at 400. Because this is not a hard one.
Keep it up! Strike over and over!
Okay, just over 400 calories in the peridot I've been missing this whole time.
Drop your hips. Straight victory!
Okay, we're done here. So yeah, that's the end of tonight's Ring Fit session, and more likely the end of tonight's stream. So, does anybody have any questions they want to ask before I wrap things up here? Something I started alluding to before, but I kind of stopped because I got really tired and out of my whole mental flow, is Saturday. Saturday is going to be kind of up in the air.
Let's
if there is a stream that day.
Stretching. You won't need the ring con.
Only because
be mindful of your body and stretch within the
Saturday
range of
I am going to help my father refinish an upper porch or an upper stoop.
While pulling on your wrist,
an upper deck.
Tilt to the right and stretch your side.
So because of that, there may not be a stream on Saturday. Again, like with all things when I say, hey, there may not be a stream. Keep your eyes on Twitter.
And bend the other way.
That will have the definitive answer if you should see a stream or not.
Don't hold your breath.
I usually tell you guys, yay or nay, if there will be a stream. And I don't know how long I'm going to be out of the house on Saturday.
Take yourself back slowly.
Depending on what plans my friends have, Monday
raise
might also be an up-in-the-air stream
too.
Because that is Memorial Day.
Stretch your upper arms while pulling your elbow downward.
So I don't know what plans they might have. But
now do the same on the opposite side.
If they don't have any plans,
be careful not to let your
I may stream that night. If they want to go do something on Memorial Day, I may be MIA then.
Bring yourself back slowly.
You will have to see.
Put your right foot forward and cross your legs. Bend your body forward and stretch the back of your left leg. Hold it like that for a little longer. Straighten up and switch legs.
Lost my balance at the very end there. Something I will say is,
stretch the opposite
if
side
I am
as well.
Not here on Saturday, I'll say this ahead of time, if I'm not here on Saturday for a stream,
slowly
watch out for NAF 38 or a ceiling. Watch out for him.
Slowly straighten up.
He's,
bit by bit,
unless they finished, unless they finished, hit him in his first finish that game, he's probably going to be playing
right
Dokapon Kingdom with,
his,
with some of his high school friends.
Bend your right knee and stretch out your left calf.
But if I can't make a stream happen
now
Saturday at any point, I will probably end up retweeting or linking his stream when it does go live.
It's okay if you're
just so you guys do have something
ground
to watch Saturday night. Monday night, again, Monday is 100% up in the air. Leaning more towards a yes, but that's still up in the air.
Bring yourself back slowly.
Chair pose.
Rotate your hands behind your back and grasp your left wrist. While pulling your wrist to the right, lower your neck the same way.
Anyway, just a second here, like normally with all streams.
Bring your neck back up and stretch in the opposite
direction. I'll list off some people
well
that are streaming right now if you guys want to go raid.
Stretching all the way from your neck.
If there's nobody
shoulder
I want to raid or nobody you guys want to go raid over to, I'll let AutoHost take over for the for who you guys go to for the rest of the evening.
Bring yourself back slowly. And your stretching is complete. Good job.
There it is. And yeah. Okay. Well, the shoes I have don't lend themselves to the type of training this game offers, so yeah. Anyway. Yeah, I'm gonna, let's go see who we can get you guys over to for the rest of the evening. As soon as I do a handful of things here. Go on here, go on. There we go. So, for a list of potential stream targets tonight, or raid targets rather, we have let's see. Scott Falco is playing Knockout City. He's throwing balls at people. Twitch sensation Gary, aka Zzix underscore, is streaming Kingdom Hearts 2 Randomizer. Good buddy Gamma is streaming Legends of Heroes Ao no Kisuke, Blue of the Sky, something like that, Blue Sky, Trails to Azure. I guess Kisuke is Trails, okay. We've learned Japanese today. Nakatalili is doing art stream, remodeling his virtual avatar for what it looks like. And Botanic Sage is playing Tolkiden 2, whatever Tolkiden 2 is. It looks like Monster Hunter. It's not Monster Hunter, Monster Hunter. Anyway, I'll run through the list again. Scott Falco, Knockout City. Zzix, Kingdom Hearts 2 Randomizer. Gamma, Legend of Heroes, Trails to Azure. Nakatuli, Arding, and Botanic Sage, Tolkiden 2. Do you folks have any preferences or anyone you want to go to specifically? If it's my choice, I'm going to send it over to Gamma. So I'll let that mull over for just a second while I finish pulling myself apart. You tear me apart, Twitch. All right. Oh, this is nice bad lighting. Why not? We'll make it a bad outro, especially with the fact I'm opening up my Steam page. All right, so let's go ahead and toss it over to Gamma. just show Gamma some love. He just finished up his semester of college. I think he finished up college in general this semester, actually. So he's a free man for a while. But say hi to him. Show him a little love if you want to. I'll be there for a second or two while he gets started. But shortly after I get we guys get settled in, I'll be dipping. So thank you all so much for watching tonight's Ring Fit session. Again, Saturday is up in the air. Monday is also up in the air. Keep eyes on Twitter for notifications. I'll see you folks then. Take care.